All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from the beautiful Oregon coast. It's a little drizzly outside. I like to kind of do the backdrop if I can out there. But instead, I'm in here. I'm next to the fire. It's the holiday season. You know, a little fireside chat. Never hurt anybody. I don't know about Tuesday night this week. We'll see how tomorrow works out a little bit, but stay tuned. But this video is about transfer portal. Transfer portal is, tis the season for the transfer portal. So Oregon gets a big running back. When I mean big running back, I mean in size and stature. Jay Harris from Northwest Missouri State. Big running back, 6'2", 220. Compiled a lot of yards last year, D2, All-American. You know, I think the transfer portal is one of those positions where I've always said this. Running backs, I think, can benefit the most. And the reason why that is, I think, is because there's a lot of guys who mature at the running back position. A lot of guys learn different things as they go. A lot of guys grow into their body. They hit the weight room, they hit the meal plan, and we've said this over and over and over the last couple of years with the NFL. The NFL has continually downgraded in their mind the necessity for feature backs. And I think we all grew up at a time where the running back was one of the most important positions on the whole field, if not the most important for the real offensive sake. And now it's completely shifted and everybody's just head over heels for the quarterback, which is fine. I understand that the quarterback has the ball in his hands every time, but the running backs are incredibly important to this game. And as the quarterbacks have become more important and have become a more key part of the game, the running backs have to protect that quarterback just as much as they have to run and open up the passing game. So the extension of the passing game with the running backs out of the flat is another part of this whole situation. So running backs have to be very versatile now. And a guy like, Jay Harris is a guy who I like, a guy who's big. I'm sick. At my purest form, I should probably be 220. That was when I was at my peak. But now I'm probably about 250. Too much beer. The idea is that these guys, I love a big running back, and I always have. I think they set the tone. I think they're really nice in, obviously, short yardage, goal line situations. But I think they're really nice in open field situations just as much. You can do a lot with them, and a guy who's quick enough on his feet, who can pick up a block, those kind of guys are really important. And if Oregon wants to play a passing game where the ball's in the air a lot more than it is running, even though they run the ball and pass the ball fairly evenly, right? They're a very balanced offense. The ball's still in the air a lot. And if that's the case and you're a running back, well, you know, you have to find a place to be successful. And I think, like I said, going back to the first statement, transfer portal, I think, is really beneficial to running backs. I think running backs can come into a spot, make an impact on day one. I mean, look at what happened with Bucky Irving and Noah Whittington. And all signs say that Noah's going to come back. I've heard rumblings. You know, every year with transfer portal, you say, there's people who say, oh, everybody's gone. And that could be the case. But, you know, I've from what I've gathered, it feels like you'll see Noah as the feature back next year. Obviously, Jay Harris will get a lot of run there. And then I think Jordan James is really a guy who's developing into an all-round back, a guy who's not just a power back as he was as a freshman, a guy who's really toned down, really transformed his body a little bit to be a very, very dynamic player. And I would not be surprised at all to see him be the number one guy as the year progresses next year. And no offense, no slight to Noah. I think Noah Whittington is a great running back, and I think he does a lot of really good things, especially out of the backfield. I think he does really well in the screen game. I think he does really well out of the backfield and the flat. Catching the ball, and he does well after contact as well. So he should have a phenomenal year next year. But I think Jordan James is rounding into a guy who's just really, really versatile. So to add Jay Harris to that, you're set. And then not to mention the fact that you've got other guys in that room. You obviously are bringing in guys recruiting. And Coach Lachlan, you got to give some shouts out to Coach Lachlan as well, man. You know, I think Coach Locke is a guy who it might not be the easiest guy to play for. And I think anybody who's been around coaching and who's been a player and who's been a coach knows that sometimes those are your best coaches. Guys who are going to coach you hard. Guys that are going to demand a lot from you. Guys that are going to have high expectations. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. And I think that Coach Locke comes at it from a different perspective a little bit than maybe he's the average guy because of his own story, his work ethic, what he had to do. And you know, he's said it over and over and over that he wants his running back room to have the type of mentality that he has. And I love the pictures of him and Jay Harris together, Coach Locke in the retro sweatshirt. Shouts out to Nike, by the way. That retro sweatshirt's phenomenal. I see a lot of people with that on the road, everything else, with the stripes on the arm. That's going to go down as one of the better sweatshirts in modern time. That's a great, great sweatshirt. So shouts out that. But, you know, he's just a big dude. And when you stand next to Coach Locke and when you interact with Coach Locke, you see a guy who also does not shy away from the weight room. My guy is thick. And he is built like you want to see a running back built. And I think he envisions a running back room where your running backs are closer to the weight that you see, 200, maybe 200 plus. You know, Bucky was a unique back at 190. He felt much, much stronger, and he ran bigger than 190, it felt like, heavier than 190, but still light on his feet, bouncy. But I think that Coach Locke envisions a running back room where most of these guys sit right around 5'10", 200 pounds, 210, 208, 205, maybe under that, 195, but all those are thick backs. Oregon's had backs at 170, 175. So, and all the way up bigger than that, right? So, 220 backs, right? But I think the important thing about a guy like Jay Harris, especially when we put the film on, I went through a little quick highlight reel this morning, and it looks good. I mean, the key thing about a guy at that size is, and this is why I've always liked a big running back, is because not only can you get through the line, which is always kind of the cliche thing, right? The idea that you're a bigger guy so you can be able to handle the bigger guys on the offense or defensive line. That's one part. But I think it really, really shows up at the next stage, right? Getting to the linebackers, getting on the next level, and really what you can do there. We saw with LeGarrette Blount, who's probably one of the better examples of this, big back, is very nimble on his feet as well. And guys like LeGarrette Blount don't show up every day on your roster. Those guys are few and far between. But a guy like Jay Harris, when I put the film on, that's who kind of reminds me of a little bit, because he's still very light on his feet, can jiggle a little bit, can work the angle a little bit. Because half of running back is just working angles, right? Understanding where to be, how to be there, when to be there. In letting a block develop and letting a crease open up, understanding the angle of which to hit that crease to be able to get the maximized speed to be able to get through. All those kind of things are all running back things. And again, very, very, very versatile athletes who are great, super quick thinking and let the game come to them a little bit, but also read and react, also plan where they're supposed to be. I mean, they have a lot on their mind. They have to juggle a lot. So what I see from Jay Harris is a guy who can come in immediately and play, a guy who can give you quality reps when you need it. And, you know, to be honest, where has Oregon needed some help? Short yardage situations. There's been some issues in the last couple years where, you know, to be honest, you needed a first down, you couldn't get it. So not to say that they didn't cash in a lot of those first downs. They did. And using the running back, using the quarterback, that sort of stuff. But, you know, Bo was like a big running back. You know, he's obviously a great quarterback and has evolved into being a great quarterback. But his size and strength, he's built like a big running back. So when you needed a yard or two, you could get it with Bo. It's nice to be able to hand the thing off and let a running back do it. It's nice to keep your quarterback out of those harm's way, especially when you got a guy like Dylan Gabriel next year who's a one-time, one-year rental. You got to do it. You got to do it now. You can't throw him into the freaking pile. So I really like a guy like Jay Harris be able to come in here, play on day one, make an impact on day one. And I think that's a big thing for a playing time. Let's speak on transfer portal just for a second. This is a perfect example of why the transfer portal is so great. Because you can have a guy who's a great player on the D2 level, jump to the D1 level, and make an impact on day one. That's very unique. Now, is he going to win the Heisman next year? No. But he's going to come into a team that's a very good team, that's a solid running back room, that has room to grow, okay, and really make an impact with room to grow. That's huge. So when you're looking at the transfer portal, what's the best thing about the transfer portal? Guys being able to get into a better situation, improve their draft stock, improve themselves, improve their life, improve their family standing, everything else, get into some NIL money, get into some other sort of opportunity, network, get to an opportunity like Oregon. Come on. What's wrong with any of those things? Again, I know a lot of people speak out about transfer portal, but I think this is a perfect story. A guy like Jay Harris, perfect example of why the transfer portal really is awesome and why teams like Oregon should constantly be looking at not only the D1 level, the competitors that are out there, guys who are maybe on your neighboring roster or some down the road or whatever, guys you've seen before, but also digging through all the other levels of football and seeing there's some guys out there that can jump to the next level and make the difference now. Maybe the timing wasn't right when they were coming out of high school. Maybe they didn't get the right offers because they were hurt. Maybe they had something going on with their academics. Maybe there was something, family issues. Maybe they were moving. Maybe there's a variety of different levels of reasons why guys are not all on the same page at the same time freshman year going into a D1. Okay, a lot of guys want to go to a JUCO. A lot of guys want to come out. We've seen great players come out of the JUCO leagues, right? Junior college players have historically come out with better discipline than they had coming out of high school. Had already some year in the weight room or two. Already on a meal plan or two. Already away from home. Start to self-identify a little bit. Different atmosphere, different environment. So, and I just love Coach Locke. I've got a lot of appreciation for Coach Locke. And he's a guy who I really believe in. And I think if he believes in a player, then the rest of the Ducks should believe in that player as well. So cheers to Jay Harris, his family. Cheers to Coach Locke. Cheers to the offense. And again, I think there's going to be more names coming in the coming days or weeks or whatever with the transfer portal. So stay tuned. I'll see what I can do on the live stream tomorrow. We'll see. We're out here at the coast. So, you know, we're planning. I might be on the golf course. If it's not, you know, I might be. Might be a little late. So might be a little later tomorrow. All right. We'll talk to you guys soon. Thank you guys so much for watching Sports Chat 503. Have a happy holiday. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year to everybody's families out there. And we'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much. Adios. And of course, as always, go Ducks.